your hand, hold me still. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. I'm fearfully.
Hi, this is Bill Reichert, National Director for Campus and Community Ministries here at CMDA. I want to thank you so much for taking the time to join us, to be a part of this time together, to come together as part of CMDA's community, to hear from God and to seek Him. And I think you would agree with me that these are difficult, trying, and tumultuous times. And more than ever, we just need to be able to hear from God, hear from His Word, and come together as God's people and seek after Him. And so in just a minute, we're going to hear from Dr. Emily Ferrara, who's going to open up God's Word. But before she does, let me invite you down below to put in your prayer requests in the comments section. We take those prayer concerns seriously. They're important to us to be able to hear from you, our members, on how to best pray for you. So do put those down below. These can be prayer requests for your family, friends, your community, any ways that we can pray for you. Put those in the comments section. We greatly appreciate that. Well, I want to introduce our speaker today, and that is Dr. Emily Ferrara, who has been a CMDA leader for many years. She's part of the CMDA Atlanta Local Leadership Council. She's been on GHO trips around the world. She served in many different ways within CMDA. She has been a licensed professional counselor for many years in Atlanta. She got her PhD in Christian counseling from the International University. And as I said, has been serving local medical professionals, particularly medical students, in how to deal and cope with stress and personal well-being. And so I've really appreciated Emily's gifts, her service, the things, the messages that she brings to our students when I was the Atlanta Area Director. And I'm very excited that she's able to share with us today from God's Word during our devotional and prayer time. Dr. Emily Ferrara.
Hey guys, my name is Dr. Emily Ferrara, and I'm so glad to be speaking with you all today. I have gone on several trips with CMDA, I think about six or so, to El Salvador, and also have served in Atlanta on the Atlanta board for CMDA. And so CMDA is, is something that I just absolutely value and appreciate, and so it's an honor to be able to speak with you all today. I'm a therapist here in Atlanta, and I specialize in anxiety disorders. And as you would imagine, it is pretty busy here. The need for anxiety, specifically therapist, has been high already, but that has grown exponentially due to COVID and all of the unknowns. And whether it's anxiety, just general anxiety, or anxiety related to health, health-related issues, OCD, phobias, panic attacks, you name it. And I think that no matter who's coming in, one of the common themes that I hear is this constant fear of living with the unknowns. It's kind of this messy middle of a space. I think if that's true of them, it's probably true of us. Living with the unknowns, not knowing what is going to be our new normal and when that's going to be, not knowing about a vaccine or when life is going to get back as it should be. We also, I think for work, some people are having to be furloughed because they're not in as high need, and then others are on the front lines and it is just nonstop and they just need a break, need a breather. I think that unknown is one of the anthems and the themes for this season, even as believers. I think the unknown of when are we going to be able to be around other people, our loved ones, our family members, those who are elderly. And I don't know about you, but one thing that I've really missed more than ever is just my church community. It is wonderful watching someone worship online, but it is not the same as being in the presence of the Lord in worship with other people in community, and just hearing the praises of God and those around me, and having truth spoken over me as well. That's something I've really missed, and I'm so, so thankful for online church. That's awesome. But it does not compare at all with being around other believers. And so all these things that we're struggling with, and all these unknowns, and I think that in times of such uncertainty, it's important to be able to hold on to what is known, what is truth. And there's a fun little exercise that I want to offer to you guys. But first, I'm going to read in Joshua, and this is from Joshua 4, and it's after the Israelites crossed the Jordan. Two times in scripture, at this point, it had happened. Once was with the Red Sea, and where the Lord dried up the Red Sea, and then also with the Jordan River. So I'll start in 4, 4:1, let's start there. When all the nation had finished passing over the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, "Take 12 men from the people, from each tribe a man, and command them, saying, take 12 stones from here, out of the midst of the Jordan, from the very place where the priest's feet stood firmly, and bring them over here with you, and lay them down in the place where you lodge tonight." Then Joshua called the 12 men from the people of Israel, whom he had appointed, a man from each tribe. And Joshua said to them, "Pass on before the ark of the Lord, your God, into the midst of the Jordan, and take up each of you a stone upon his shoulder, according to the number of the tribes of the people of Israel, that this may be a sign among you. And when your children ask in times to come, 'What do these stones mean to you?' then you shall say to them that the waters of the Jordan were cut off before the ark of the covenant of the Lord. And when it passed over the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off. So these stones shall be to the people of Israel a memorial forever." If we go on to 21, he said to the people of Israel, "When your children ask their fathers in times to come, 'What do these stones mean?' then you shall let the children know, 'Israel passed over this Jordan onto dry land. For the Lord your God dried up the waters of the Jordan for you until you passed over. And as the Lord your God did in the Red Sea, which he dried up for the people until we passed over, so that all the people of the earth may know that the hand of the Lord is mighty, and that you may fear the Lord your God forever." Friends, there is an opportunity for us to hold on to this. In the midst of unknowns, just as it was true for the Israelites, it's true for us. And I want to encourage you to get rocks, and for you to make your own stones. Whether you are single or whether you are in a family, I would love for you to do this. And on one side of the stone, write a date and a situation. We have all had the impossible happen in our life. We have all, if you live on this earth long enough, we will have faced hardship because it's life outside the garden. And so I want to encourage you to take some rocks and to write down a date and a situation where God was faithful. And then on the other side of it, I want you to write down a name of God, what he was to you in that moment. Maybe it was El Elohim. Maybe it was El Shaddai. Maybe it was Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides. Maybe it was Emmanuel, and God showed you that he was with you in the midst. Whatever that was, I want to encourage for you to do that and to write several out. Because friends, God's past faithfulness is always promise of his future provision. And there are unknowns. Maybe I listed them earlier. Maybe there are unknowns that I haven't even gone through. But these are unknowns that are painful realities in your life. And it's at this time that we get to call upon the goodness of God, and we get to be able to say, this is truth. Even though this is undone and this is unsure, this is truth. I also want to encourage you to hold on to some rocks and actually don't write on them, because it reminds us of our faith. It reminds us that we are holding on to hope, and that we know and accept that it is a reality, that this side of eternity, we will have more challenges. And it might not be a pandemic. It might be a death. It might be a miscarriage. It might be a divorce. It might be fill in the blanks. But the God who is faithful in those past situations will prove to be faithful in those as well, and in what you're facing and what you will face. I know this to be true for me. you guys might not know this, but I just got married. And it wasn't until my late 30s that I got married. My husband is actually in his later 40s. We've both never been married, but we've committed our life to service and to ministry and doing the work that God has before us. And for me, I know that that a lot of my friends, about 8 of my friends outside of college, got married immediately after college. And I was so excited to be a bridesmaid. And then I realized, I think I'm in this, it was like the, I think it's 27 dresses about the bridesmaids. I was like, this is my life. Like, this is not funny. You know, I had to turn it off because it was just one after the other, getting married, having babies, having more babies. And just knowing that that was a big desire of my heart and it was not being met. And I remember holding on to this and doing this stones exercise, especially after one time in particular, there was a really, really painful breakup. And I thought we were gonna get married and it did not work out. And I remember holding on to this and saying, you know, just as much as such as much pain as I'm going through right now in the midst of this breakup, I'm going to defy what my feelings say. I'm going to say that God is just as faithful in this moment as he will be on my wedding day. And holding to that truth that my current circumstances do not dictate God's faithfulness and his goodness. And a scripture that I loved holding on to during this time comes from Psalms 27. And it says, I believe that I shall look upon the goodness of God in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong, let your heart take courage, wait for the Lord. And so I hope that my story encourages you and yours. I think that no matter what we're going through, we're all in this season with this pandemic and the things that were happening before and after that just highlight the uncertainty that we have. And so as you're in this space, I want us to really hold on to what God has done in the past and to be able to claim those truths and to be able to ask God to show us how he is going to be that in our current reality and also give us hope for the future. Honor the pain, but also put that pain under the shadow of his provision for you. I'm going to read to you one of my favorite songs that they sing at my church. It's by Sandra McCracken. And if you want to close your eyes and just listen to the lyrics or just listen as I read along, feel free to do so. But I think that this so sums up our future hope. This is what helps us walk through this messy middle because there's something else on the other side and this is what we ultimately are going for. It says, we will feast in the house of Zion. We will sing with our hearts restored. He has done great things. We will say together, we will feast and weep no more. We will not be burned by the fire. He is the Lord our God. We are not consumed by the flood, upheld, protected, and gathered up. In the midst of night, before the dawn, my soul be not afraid. For the promised morning, oh, how long, O God of Jacob, be my strength. Every vow we've broken and betrayed, God, you are the faithful one. And from the garden to the grave, bind us together and bring shalom. We will feast in the house of Zion. We will sing with our hearts restored. He has done great things, we will say together. We will feast and weep no more. And friends, I pray that you remind daily of God's goodness for you, his provisions in the past, and recall them and tell them amongst one another. See his provisions that he has for you today in this moment and hold on to hope into this place where there will be no weeping, there will be no sorrow, and we will be in our Savior's presence. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you, Emily, for sharing what you did from God's word today. I've invited Paul Montgomery, our Senior Director of Stewardship and Legacy Gifts, to offer a prayer for those of you, our CMDA members today. Paul?
If you would, just join me in prayer, please. Father God, we come this afternoon thanking you for your blessings you have bestowed on this organization. Father, we thank you for today being the first day back for all CMDA members here in the building. Father, we just pray that we continue to practice safe distancing between each other. And Father, we also pray that your covering be upon us, that the COVID-19 disease will not be a part of our lives. Father, we thank you that you've kept us safe thus far. We're praying for those, not only in this building, but those members who are out in the field and doing your work that you've called them to do. Father, we think it's a privilege that we can serve you in so many different ways. And we thank you that you continue to bless us in spite of all that we are and all that we do. So thank you for forgiving us of our sins. Thank you for covering us and your blessings and your grace beyond us. These are the things we say. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Paul. And I hope again next week, same time, Wednesdays at 12 p.m. Eastern, for 15 minutes, so you'll take the time and join with us as we open up God's Word and pray together. Thank you and God bless.